Hello, everyone. In the previous video, we saw how we can take an application from AWS and move it over to Azure AD. In this video, I'm going to demonstrate a couple of things that you can do with the built-in capabilities around governance and security with Azure AD, and then you move to what we call the managed phase of the application.
Okay, so now that Luis configured ServiceNow with Azure AD for SSO, let's see what else can we do for identity and access management. The first thing that I want to show you here is provisioning. So here I configured the credentials in ServiceNow to integrate Azure AD with the ServiceNow APIs for provisioning. What this is going to allow us is to have a consistent lifecycle when the user is updated or when the user is removed to access. We just call the ServiceNow APIs and keep things consistent. Now, this next level of capabilities is to bundle them in another capability in Azure AD that's called entitlement management. And what I'm going to show you here is how can you take ServiceNow and bundle it with other resources. In this case, I took a SharePoint site and then manage those things as a bundle. What is part of that? So I'm going to show you here the policies that you can create to determine who can request access to this package. So the first thing here is in the requests, I say that people outside this tenant can have access. And here further down, I specify what tenants in Azure AD are going to be allowed. And another thing that I want to show you is that the lifecycle of an access package is time bound. So here I'm saying that every request is going to be expiring after a year, and every quarter you're going to have access reviews. So as you can see, you have lifecycle, time bound, access to multiple resources, and you manage them cohesively. So what I'm going to ask Luis now is to go and request access to this package. So each package has a link that allows users to request access. So Luis is going to use another account that he has in another tenant that hasn't been created in this environment yet. So Luis, over to you.
Here I am in my apps for Woodruff. My apps is a portal where for end users to see all their applications that they have assigned. So here you can see GitHub, Box. You can organize them in very cool collections. So Ramiro, I'm just going to access the link you sent me.
Correct.
Okay. Okay, I see this package. So I believe I just select the package and click on Request Accessed.
Correct.
I'm just going to run it. Ask me to request. Okay, I check this. Now I'm going to submit the request. Okay, Ramiro, so now what should I expect?
So now that you requested the access, then Azure AD under the covers is going to assign you to the different resources that are part of the package, and ServiceNow is one of them. Since user provision is enabled automatically for ServiceNow, you will also be provisioned directly into ServiceNow for you to sign in and have your profile all ready to go. Then, since I configured access review every 3 months, you will receive a reminder in 3 months from now asking to confirm that you still need access to ServiceNow. But since you keep ignoring all my emails all the time, you probably is going to lose access.
Well, you can complain now. I respond pretty quickly on Teams.
Cool. So if you click in view here, you should see how the request is going, and there's a workflow that completed.
Okay, cool.
Yeah.
Nice.
Okay, so we waited a couple minutes, and now this workflow completed. So let's try getting to ServiceNow.
Okay, I'm going to try to log into ServiceNow. Okay, get asked for my credentials.
So here you're typing your Woodruff credentials. So you're not typing, this is your own tenant.
Okay, so now that you log in, this is the first time, and this is another capability that Azure AD provides as part of the B2B collaboration, is that every guest that logs in for the first time has to consent to be onboarded into that other tenant.
Okay, so here basically I'm consenting that I want to share my name, email address, and picture with your tenant, right?
Correct.
Okay, I trust you, so I'm just going to consent. So now I see here MFA. I think like I'm going to skip it for now just because this is a demo, but please don't do this in production. So I'm just going to skip it.
Correct. And just to summarize, what you see here is Luis did all this access self-service. So I just sent him a link, and then he was able to request access by himself through self-service and then get all the way to the application.
During the demo, we just saw a couple of Azure AD features, so you have a feel for it. But as you can see, Azure AD enables scenarios like activity report, risk-based authorization, passwordless authentication, and many more. In the next video, we're going to show you how you can cut the cord with ADFS and move the authentication to Azure AD.